Hi everyone and welcome back to another Placeit tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you step by step how to create iPhone mockups using Placeit. Currently there are 77 different pages of mockups, and at the top here you can sort them by whatever iPhone you would like to use for your mockup. Additionally, towards the end of this video, I'm going to show you how to create completely free mockups for those of you who do not have a paid subscription to Placeit.net. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so in today's video, we are going to be focusing solely on iPhone mockups. Now, first things first, before we get started, this tutorial is going to be made using Placeit.net. And for those of you who are new to Placeit, it is a paid website, so you do have to pay to create an account to use their features. Now, for those of you who don't already have a Placeit account, I've gone ahead and put my referral link down in the description. And the cool thing is that referral link comes with 15% off for anyone who uses it. Now, for those of you who can't afford a Placeit subscription right now, stick around to the end of this video because I'll show you the few options for creating free iPhone mockups on Placeit.net towards the end of this video. All right, with that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started with this tutorial. So the first thing we're going to do is just go to the Placeit homepage and hover over mockups and then take our cursor over to iPhones. Go ahead and click iPhones and it'll bring us to their iPhone page. Now, right off the bat, Placeit is going to show you a lot of their iPhone mockups, and as you hover over them, you can see different variations of what they look like mocked up. Now, a few things I want to show you is towards the bottom, you will see these pages likely when you're watching this tutorial. There are more than 77, and that's because Placeit is constantly adding new designs. Now, a couple other important things are if you come up top, you can sort this, and you can go for exactly the iPhone you are looking to mock up. And then over on the left side, something I can definitely pass on from experience is you can hit this down arrow, and you can switch it to best-selling or newest. And by doing this, it's going to show you generally the best designs that are most often downloaded. And for iPhone mockups, these are going to be your basic ones. And then additionally, some of the cooler backdrops. Now further on the left side, if you are looking for something very specific, you can select from their categories to narrow down what's in the search results. So let's go ahead and choose one of these basic ones here just so we can get started and show you what this looks like. So once you reach this page, you are officially in the mockup editor, and I'll start on the left side and go through everything so you know exactly how to use all of the features. Starting on the left side here, we have add text. Now when you add text, we can click this and it's not actually going to add to the mockup, but it will add to your image. So if you do need to add text to the side or somewhere in your mockup, this is the way that you would do it. Now to edit this text, you just come over to the side. You can highlight this and change what the text says. You can change the font from this dropdown. And you can even change the font color, and then the text background. If you want to remove that, just turn the checkerboard on. So as you can see now, just by clicking off of that, we have text without a background. We can put that anywhere on our image. Now, if you need to add more text, just go ahead and click add another text. And then if you want to remove any of these texts, you can just turn them off on the left side. So that should cover text for us. And now we get into the main function of the mockup. So there's two ways that you can do this. Number one is you can upload your own image. This is the exact aspect ratio. However, don't worry if your photo isn't exactly that because you can crop it. For example, I'm just going to click to upload an apparel mockup that I created in a previous tutorial, and I'll show you how that works with the cropping. So all you do is click the button and it'll let you choose a file from your computer. And once you select that, it'll allow you to crop it. Now, as you can see, this is the exact size that it's looking for the phone screen. So if we were to leave it like this and not go all the way to fill the screen, it'll show that there are gaps at the top and bottom. Now I'm going to click crop to show you what that looks like. Now, as you can see, there is a white gap at the top and at the bottom. So if we go back into crop again, which is this little button right here, we can go ahead and adjust this. So I'm going to zoom in all the way until it covers the top and the bottom, just about there. I'll center this up and then I'll hit crop again. And this is effectively how you control the image within the mockup. Now, if you want to get rid of this image and start over, you can either just click upload image again and select a different one, or you can click X and it'll start you over from the beginning. Now, a couple things to note here. If you do want to show off a specific page or feature on your app or your website, you can go onto your smartphone and you can screenshot it, and then you can upload that screenshot and put it right onto the iPhone mockup. Now with that said, that takes care of upload the image. Now what is this from URL button? This is actually one of my favorite features for their iPhone mockups. If you just need to have your mockup of an actual website that's live right now, you can go to from URL and you can type in the exact URL with the page that you want to have mocked up on the screen, and it'll do the rest for you. So for example, if we type in placeit.net and we go ahead and hit go, just give this a couple seconds to load, and what this will do is actually go to placeit.net and screenshot that current page that we inputted in the URL. and put it right into the mockup for us. Now, additionally, if we do need to go in and crop it even further than this for a specific reason, then we could do that here, but if we don't need to, we can just leave it as is. Now, that should take care of our left side over here, and that should give you a good idea how to use it. Now, let's go over to the right side. The only button we have on the right side is Add Graphic. Now, when we click this, it's going to add in a graphic from Placeit's graphic library. Now, every graphic that you see on the right side here in the search results, they are all commercially usable. Now, with that said, you can type right into the search box to narrow down your results. And then as you click these different icons, it'll swap out the graphic and you can change the color right up top. Now, with that said, if you need a very specific color that's not just black or one of these options listed, you can go ahead and click More. And then you can either type in the color code or you can select it right here. If you are using this selection, make sure you hit Choose before you're done. And then just click off and it'll be applied to that graphic. Now, two more things. If you don't need this graphic anymore, just go ahead and click No Image. And the last thing, which I think is the most important here, is if you need to upload your brand's logo for this mockup, just go ahead and click Custom Image. It'll bring you into the files on your computer, and you can import your brand's logo. So with that said, that is the basics of creating an iPhone mockup. Once you are ready, all you have to do is click Download. It'll give you a few reminders. Number one, saying that there are no Placeit watermarks. The format is a high-resolution PNG, and the file is 1920 pixels by 1440 pixels. Now, most importantly on here is that commercial usage is okay. What that means is if you are using this mockup on your website where you sell something and you're going to be profiting, then it is 100% legal because this comes with commercial usage rights. So all we've got to do now is click Download Now. And then just scroll up to the top here and you will see your downloads are loading. Once you get the check mark, you'll get another pop-up that says click here to download. Just go ahead and click that. It'll download right to your computer. Now, something to note is if you click this downloads at any time, it'll bring you to all of your downloads on the Placeit website. So if you need to find them in the future, that's where you find them. Now we can just go ahead and click this downloaded mockup and it'll open on our computer. So just like that, we've got our first iPhone mockup. And as you see, when you zoom in, the quality is great on here. With this specific example, we had a clear PNG transparent background. So all we've got is the mockup right here. That should be very handy to use. Now the same holds true here if we do go back to mockups and then we go to iPhones and we use a mockup that doesn't actually have a transparent background but rather has a backdrop of a person or some type of situation. As you can see, the options stay the same, and if we want to put in that same URL, we can do it again. And just like that, Placeit does all the heavy lifting for us. All we click is download, we click download again, and then we just download it to our computer and open this one up, and just like that, we have our second mockup made just in the matter of minutes here. So now, as promised in the beginning of this video, I want to show you how to create mockups on Placeit for free if you don't have a Placeit.net subscription. So all we've got to do here is hover over mockups and then go to free mockups. And what this is going to do is bring you into all of the free items that you can use on Placeit without having a subscription. Now, as you see at the bottom, there are 15 pages currently, and this will likely be going up in the future because they're constantly adding new designs and mockups. However, by looking through here, you can see that none of these are directly iPhones. So what we have to do here is, since we don't have a search at the top here, we come over to the left side and we can sort it by iPhones. So you can see iPhone 11 Pro right here. There are four different options. If we click more mockups, we can see the other iPhones. So we have 6, 8, X, and XS. So yes, this is going to be more limited since it is completely free, but you can still click on these. And if this phone is something that you're looking for, it has the free ribbon on it. So we do the same way. We just click on it. We can upload the image the same way as before. And again, we have the same functions of adding in text and adding in graphics or our own logo. So again, with this, just go ahead and click free download. As you can see, the same thing, there are no watermarks. It's the same format and commercial usage is okay. Let's just click free download. We'll go ahead and download that one to the computer as well. And as you can see, just in the matter of minutes here, we've created our third mockup, and this last one was completely free to do. So guys, I hope this tutorial has been helpful for you and guided you through how to create an iPhone mockup with Placeit.net, whether you have a subscription or not. Now keep in mind, their free ones are very limited, so if you do want access to their full library of all of the iPhone mockups, then I recommend getting yourself a Placeit subscription. Again, my referral link is down in the description. That gives you 15% off of any of their plans. So if you're thinking about signing up, hopefully that helps. All right, guys, that is it for this one. If you have any questions or future tutorial requests for Placeit.net, feel free to let me know in the comments, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next tutorial.